Hello dear students, welcome back to my science class. Today we are going to continue with the chapter Nutrition in Animals and this is part 4. So let's get going. Today we are going to learn about the small intestine and large intestine. In our previous video, we have discussed about the 5 steps of nutrition and role of mouth, esophagus and stomach in nutrition. Today we are going to learn about small intestine and large intestine. So let's begin. The small intestine is a specialized tubular structure between stomach and large intestine that absorbs the nutrition from your food. So the function of small intestine is to absorb nutrition from the food, right? So it helps in absorb nutrition from the food. It is the largest part of the alimentary canal that is about 6 meters in length. It is divided into 3 parts that is important: duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Let's see the structure of the small intestine. It's just highly coiled. You can see this structure is highly coiled because it is 6 meters long and fitted in this small place. And the 3 parts are: first is duodenum, that is the first part of the small intestine, then jejunum, then ileum. Okay. The lining of the small intestinal mucosa is highly specialized for maximizing digestion and absorption of nutrients. The lining is highly folded to form microscopic finger-like projections called villi, which increase the surface area that help in absorption of food. So just take a look. Small intestine, as it is highly coiled, you can see the structure is highly coiled, and here some finger-like projections are there that are known as villi. Okay. This finger-like projections use the surface area of absorption. We know that small intestine is the place where not only digestion completed but also digested food absorbed and sent into different parts of the body from here. So these are the villi that increase the surface area of absorption to maximize the absorption. Function: the small intestine is chiefly involved in digestion and absorption of nutrients. It secretes intestinal juice. It receives bile juice from the liver. Bile, which is produced in the liver and stored in the gallbladder. Bile is stored in gallbladder. Okay. And pancreatic juice from the pancreas, which aid in digestion. So small intestine is the place where digestion of food is completed. Digestion of food is completed means carbohydrate that is broken down into glucose, right? Proteins into amino acids, fats into glycerol and fatty acid. So these digestion completed in small intestine, and for that it received bile juice from the liver, which is stored in the gallbladder, and pancreatic juice from pancreas, and which help in digestion. Digestion is completed here. Carbohydrate turned into glucose, protein turned into amino acid, and fats into glycerol and fatty acid. Next, the intestinal juice secreted by the walls of the small intestine breaks down the starch and carbohydrate into simple sugar. These sugars are known as glucose. It also convert the proteins into amino acids. Just now we have discussed. The small intestine is responsible for absorption of nutrients, salts and water, which help in this process: the finger-like projections that are known as villi. Next part and last part of the digestive system, large intestine. The large intestine is the last part of the digestive system in vertebrates. Water is absorbed here and remaining waste material is stored as feces and being removed by defecation. So the process of removing of undigested food is known as defecation. Unlike the small intestine, the large intestine produces no digestive enzymes. Chemical digestion is completed in the small intestine. Before chyme reaches the large intestine, functions of the large intestine included the absorption of water and electrolytes. Electrolytes are salts and the elimination of feces. So the function of large intestine is to absorb water, electrolyte and help in elimination of the undigested feces. So today we have learned about the function of small intestine and large intestine. Now it is the time that I will ask you a few simple questions which you will answer me. You will quickly write down your answers in the comment section. So let's start it. First, name the three parts of the small intestine. What are the three parts of the small intestine? I hope you have written your answer already. Next, what is the name of finger-like projections of the small intestine? We just now we have learned about that helps in the absorption of food. Next, name the site where bile juice is produced. Next, name the parts of the alimentary canal where no digestion takes place. Which part of the alimentary canal no digestion takes place? Next, absorption of digested food occurs in which part of the alimentary canal? I hope you have given answer to all the questions. See you in the next video. Till then, thank you.